Raise your hand if you remember the days when you used to have to sneak certain games into your house and only play them when your parents or grandparents weren't home, or when you had to play with one foot on the power button in case your mom walked into the room. We've all been there. Heck, some of you may still be there. What is up, everybody? Chaos here. Today, we're going to be checking out some of the, I guess, the nastiest games that your mom thought was nasty that would definitely ground you for playing. And just for fairness, we're going to be doing one game per franchise. So in the comments, tell me a story. And when you got grounded for playing a video game, drop a like and let's get into it. Kicking things off is an obvious one. Dead or Alive Extreme Beach Volleyball. Let's get it out of the way. Released for the Xbox back in early 2003, Dead or Alive Extreme Beach Volleyball is a spin-off game to Dead or Alive, a fighting game franchise that started all the way back in 1996. And while it admittedly had some pretty unique fighting mechanics, it was always mainly known for its pretty outrageous and exaggerated character designs, mainly on the ladies. And back in the early 2000s, developers Team Ninja decided to go all in with that side of their game and make a beach volleyball game starring all the female characters, complete with tiny bikinis and very detailed physics. So what about the gameplay, you ask? Well, I guess it was okay, but that's not really what anybody was there for. As far as volleyball games go, I guess it was pretty good, but it was clear where most of the developmental budget went for on this game. At number 9, God of War. The original God of War was an industry changer. Now, it was admittedly a pretty blatant attempt to copy the Devil May Cry formula. It did it, though, in a unique way that made the combat feel unique, and it had a world that you really couldn't get anywhere else. God of War was set in ancient Greece, had you playing as a pissed off Spartan warrior attempting to kill all the gods of Olympus. However, it was probably a good idea to not play this game around your parents, because aside from all the insane violence, blood, and gore, God of War was chocked full of nudity, both in the regular character designs and in the interactive scenes. It kind of had you wiggling your thumbsticks and doing certain button prompts to maximize Kratos. Anyway, not exactly the thing you want your mom walking in on you playing. Kind of hard to talk your way out of that situation. Next up is Saints Row 4. The Saints Row series started back in 2006 as a blatant ripoff to Grand Theft Auto, as publisher THQ wanted to get a slice of the open world crime game pie, much like other companies at the time. But as the series progressed, it developed its own identity and shifted from being a ripoff of an open world crime game to being a parody of one. The final game in the main series, Saints Row 4, was released in August of 2013. It's a complete cluster of a game, and that is why many people think it's so great. It pulls no punches as you play as a gangster who becomes the president of the United States and then gets superpowers so they can fight off an alien invasion. So why wouldn't you want your parents seeing you play this? Well, because much like the other games in this series, Saints Row 4 is full of everything. Violence, swearing, drugs, nudity, tons of crude humor, you name it. It's a fantastic game, and I recommend it if you're old enough, but make sure your mom isn't going to walk in on you playing it. If you're enjoying the content, make sure to drop a like on the video. Make sure you're subscribed to the channel with post notifications on so you always get alerted when a new video goes up and you can get that elusive first comment. At number 7, Rambo the Video Game. There are many reasons why your parents would hate you for playing this. Aside from the obvious fact that it's a bloody realistic shooter where the sole objective is to kill bad guys and good guys, it's also a gross bastardization of a franchise that they probably grew up loving. Rambo the Video Game is a rail shooter that was released in early 2014 to horrible reviews, many calling it one of the worst video games ever produced. But not only were the developers ridiculously out of touch when they made it, they were so out of touch they released a DLC pack 2 years later. The game is a disgrace to all things gaming and all things Rambo. And if I walked in on one of my kids playing this game, they would probably be grounded instantly without question. At number 6, Postal 2. This should be another freebie. I mean, yeah. It was released back in 2003, a full 6 years after the first one. It was designed to be the most offensive thing possible in just about every manner. And you may ask, did it succeed? Well, it's over 15 years old and people still reference it to being one of the most offensive games ever made. So I would say, yes, it has everything. Guns, knives, violence, dismemberment, tons of blood, nudity, swearing, taboo topics, and even a dash of all kinds of stuff. The game was banned from several countries and it was ripped apart by critics for its content. Also, it wasn't a good game. However, you can find some fun in the sheer ridiculousness of it, which was kind of the goal all along, I guess. I'm putting it down at number 6 because while it does have a lot of ridiculously offensive content, it's also 16 years old and it's extremely dated. If your mom caught you playing this, chances are she would just say, that game looks like crap, and then she would ground you. Cracking into the top 5, Gears of War 3. Now, Gears has always been a pretty controversial title when it came to the content. Sure, the series was very influential, and the original trilogy pretty much redefined what we expect from third-person shooters, but given it was created by Epic Games in the mid-2000s, that meant there was plenty of over-the-top violence. Now, Gears doesn't really have any sexual content like the other games on this list, but it has practically everything else your parents would hate. Guns, blood, gore, dismemberment, executions, constant profanity, and your starting weapon is a freaking assault rifle with a chainsaw attached to it. Now, when it comes to picking one for the list, I'm going to go with Gears 3. It looked far more realistic than the previous two games and was less cartoony than Gears 4, giving it that sweet spot of cheesy and realistic violence that your parents probably wouldn't like. At number 4, Mortal Kombat 9. Now, MK has always been a controversial series. That's what they're made off of. Heck, the original game is one of the reasons why the ESRB rating was ever created in the first place. It was a little tough, though, to narrow it down to one game for this list, but after hours of examination, not really, I decided to go with MK9. Full reboot of the franchise, and the first outing for current developers, NetherRealms, and they decided to make their interest as grand as possible. MK9 featured the most graphic and bloody violence the series has ever seen, thanks to the updated engine and the character models that allowed for more creative dismemberment, and it also featured tons of skimpy outfits for all the female characters. It wasn't as dark and gritty as MKX and MK11, but it was definitely more over the top and certainly embraced the sex appeal that was erased by future installments. Chances are your parents would hate all Mortal Kombat games, but if we're just picking the single most offensive one, I think the title goes to MK9. Next up is Playboy the Mansion. Did you guys know there was a Playboy game? There's actually multiple ones. The idea behind it was actually interesting. When you start the game up, you take control of Hugh Hefner in his younger years, and it tasks you with building the Playboy brand from scratch and getting it up to the status that it eventually got to. It plays out like a business simulator as you build the Playboy Mansion, you customize it to your liking, but you also work on building relationships both personally and for the business. It got mediocre reviews when it came out to the PS2, Xbox, and PC in early 2005, and given that it's a detailed game about the Playboy brand, you can probably guess why your parents wouldn't be fans of it. Yes, it's full of everything Playboy-esque. Many critics even wrote off Playboy the Mansion as just being an excuse to show all those things off. So you might want to stay away from this one. At number 2, this is a game I actually played. Well, I played one of them. Leisure Suit Larry Magna Cum Laude. Now, speaking of games that don't shy away from everything, the Leisure Suit Larry series has always been one of those, and while the actual quality of the games has been up and down, pretty much all of them will fit on this list. But if I had to choose, I'm gonna go with this one. Released in 2004 for the PC, PS2, and Xbox, you played as Larry Lovage, the nephew of the original protagonist, as you attend community college and attempt to seduce as many women as possible. Now, there's a more detailed plot going on in the background, but come on, you're playing Leisure Suit Larry. You're not worried about the plot. The writing is actually pretty good, as was the case with almost all the Larry games, boasting some great jokes and witty comedy. But the gameplay, it was garbage. Also, compared to other Leisure Suit games, the nudity and the content, well, it was more obvious and in your face, which is what gets it on today's list. Series creator Outlaw even denounced the game due to its content, claiming that he had nothing to do with its creation and didn't want to be associated with it. That's not good. If you're enjoying the content, make sure to drop a like on the video. Make sure you're subscribed to the channel with post notifications on so you always get alerted when a new video goes up and you can get that elusive first comment. And at number 1 today, Duke Nukem Forever. Finishing off our list is a game that offended just about everybody. It offended parents by containing just about everything they don't want to see in a video game. It offended gamers for being in development for 15 years only to become one of the worst games ever made. Released in 2011 after a long development that jumped from studio to studio, Duke Nukem Forever is a game where you play as an iconic character in a new adventure that serves as a sequel to Duke Nukem 3D, which came out in 96. Duke has always been pretty appropriate. I mean, that's part of it. There's lots of bad stuff in it, but the jokes were usually good. It was constantly making fun of itself for being stupid, but Duke Nukem Forever, on the other hand, didn't get the second part of that memo, and instead just threw up a whole bunch of offensive things on the screen and hoped we would connect the dots. Violence, gore, nudity, strip clubs, alcohol, extremely inappropriate writing. It's everything. I mean, if you want offensive content, it was there. And just remember Duke Nukem Forever. You suck and you will always be remembered as one of the biggest disappointments in gaming history. And there you go, my friends. Those are 10, I guess, nasty games that your mom would ground you for playing if she caught you. Let me know one game that didn't make this list that was deserving. Give us your story if you've ever got caught. Drop a like, make sure you subscribe, turn on those post notifications, and I'll see you soon.